हमें ऐसी शिक्षा चाहिए जिससे चरित्र का निर्माण हो, मन की शक्ति बढ़े, बुद्धि का विकास हो और मनुष्य अपने पैर पर खड़ा हो सके। नमस्ते एवरीवन, आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन टुडे गोज विद द कोट वेरी वेल, दैट इज चैलेंजेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर फैकल्टी टीचिंग इंडियन ईथोस एंड वैल्यूज एंड कल्चर। I and my colleague Dr. Richa Chauhan will share our thoughts on the topic to have more clarity. Today, there is a concern about diminishing ethics and values among the communities and groups that make our great nation. What makes us worry is the sad reality that the changing education system is fantasized by the Western culture and has made serious difference in the regard to moral values and ethics among the students. It is really important to make our students aware about the richness and implications of their own culture and ethics. In fact, the education system we are having nowadays in our country somewhere contributing to this deeply. At times, the decline awareness among the students about our rich literature bothers me. Like, in our country, people are using their own native languages to communicate and learn other languages just as per the requirements. In our own country, people are not giving priority to their own mother tongue, whereas in Western countries, people are proudly using their mother tongue to communicate. Other countries are realizing the importance of our scriptures and culture, as Germany is having the world's largest college of Sanskrit, but the language belongs to India. They only teach Sanskrit, but the implication will not tell by no one better than an Indian.
The role of Indian ethics and culture within higher education system is declining and requires a new way of thinking. Education only helps in opening the door of mind, clean the soul and helps in self-realization, where colleges and universities are playing major role as they are a custodian of knowledge. They create and disseminate knowledge among the future generation and in way to contributing towards the economic and the social life throughout the world. Institutions have responsibility to maintain the well-being of students. Majority of unethical work is done students due to lack of moral values and ethical preaching. Earlier, the few institutions focusing on Indian ethics and culture like Banasthali Vidyapith, Banaras Hindu University, but the changing values and the culture, now most of the reputed institutions are also inculcating these values. The institutions are looking for the faculties who can teach these subjects, Indian ethics and culture, because it's not an everybody cup of tea. The purpose of including Indian ethos and culture in the curriculum is to enhance the quality of cultural awareness among the students, make students able to appreciate the Indian world of arts, music and literature and the richness of their own culture and tradition. It is a sad reality that most of our young generation do not have sufficient knowledge of the strength of their own culture. India has been multicultural, multi-religious, multilinguistic culture and a different culture with tradition. Faculties, those are teaching subjects related with Indian ethics and ethos, they have some pros and cons.
Faculty is facing many challenges while teaching these subjects. The first question is that a big why from the students. The students always think that why they have to study that subject.
Being in the faculty of Bharatiya Prabandhan, in my perspective, it is our first and foremost responsibility to tell them students about the objectives of the course. With a changing scenario, under the Western influence, it is very important to imbibe our culture and values among the students, because without them, they are body without the soul. In today's ills are the result of degradation in our own value system and low moral values in character. Forces of severe competition in the technological era of globalization and liberalization have taken heavy charge of traditional values. Education system need to re-imbibe the Sanatan value of honesty, integrity, compassion, sympathy and teamwork. There is an urgent need to establish culture based on truth, non-violence, peace and harmony. Institutions and faculties need to promote a secular value that entails Sarv Dharma Sambhav. That alone promote enshrined in our own ancient wisdom matrix of Vasudeva Kutumbakam.
It means that the whole world is a big family?
True. This will be India's distinctive contribution towards improvement in content of globalization, which today has its focus only on trade and commerce. Neelni, students always have one question in their mind when they are exploring these subjects. What is the implication of these subjects in their personal and the professional lives?
Yes, ma'am, you're absolutely right. I always say, face the same question when I entered into my class for the first time. They always have question that how they inculcate these things in their professional and personal life. So let me clear, professional excellence is the effectiveness and punctuality reflected in the person working lifestyle. Our coming managers need to learn the art of doing right things instead doing things right. Both the approaches are entirely different, because if we talk about the first approach, then in the first approach, the work is done by hook or by crook. They not necessarily follow the unethical ethical approach. They always focus on unethical part. But when compare other approach, then they are more ethical in their approaches to achieve the goals and objectives. In the second approach, the process done with proper planning and timely implementation, without compromising values and ethics. The action which are defined, dharma, roles and responsibility taken by the manager for the way organizations always give best and expected results.
But don't you think, Neelni ji, there is also one challenge students are facing or faculties are facing when they are taking these subjects? What is to be taught and how it is to be taught?
Yes, ma'am, you are absolutely right. It's a big challenge for us. Indian ethos is a very deep and wide that include the Indian Hindu scriptures and Indian culture as is depicted in the epic like Ramayana and Mahabharata and holy books like Bhagavad Gita and Vedas. It is difficult to inculcate the approaches of Indian ethos with a materialistic mindset where the only concern is to achieve goals by hook or by crook rather than focusing on the processes and paths.
Yes, you are right, Neelni ji. Indian ethos give impetus to the means adopted to achieve a goal rather than goal itself. If the process means are defined properly, excellence which automatically be achieved even in the end results. Thus, harnessing skills based on Indian ethics and culture in a proper way among students always leads to perfection and helps them in manifest all-round excellence. Faculty needs to teach concept from the Vedic literature on the basis of the students' levels, because understanding level difference with the age group of the students. We cannot teach students deep concepts at their initial phase of life. First, we need to furnish their personality with the basic concepts which develop morality among them.
But I think there is one more challenge, that the language understanding is far beyond the approach of students. It's a task for the teacher to translate the concept from Indian scriptures in a way that is understandable by the students. Most of the Indian scriptures are written in Sanskrit and Hindi, and under the influence of westernization, they are communicating more in English, which makes student losing command on Hindi. It's a task for the teacher to translate concept from Indian scripture in a way that is understandable by the student. Most of the scriptures are written in Sanskrit and Hindi, and under the influence of westernization, they are communicating more in English, which makes students losing their command on Hindi.
I think it is really tough to capture the student or interest of the student in these kind of subjects, don't you think so?
But how to deal with the situation?
When I started taking classes initially, students show resistance towards these subjects. But as the flow of class is going on, their interests are created because they are clear about the objective of the content.
Might be the possibility is that the subject is mostly in Hindi.
That could be one reason, but now we have a books in English also. To indulge student, I include many activities to make curriculum interesting, because when students are practically involved, they have better understanding about the concepts. I include shloka antakshari, case studies, managerial implication from our Indian scriptures, role plays, skit, so that which improve their concept clarity as well.
The language ability of students in context of scriptures is not very good. In present generation, students are rarely communicating in their mother tongue, as English has been made compulsory across the education system due to global competition. The changing pattern makes students losing command over their mother tongue, and when subjects related to ethics and culture will teach them, they find it difficult to understand.
Along with various challenges, Indian ethics and ethos has its own importance as in a subject, like quest for perfection. The pervasiveness of the quality is also reflected by the shloka of Vallabhacharya, who found every aspect of Lord Krishna beautiful. Adharam madhuram, vadinam madhuram, हृदयम मधुरम नयनम मधुरम हसितम मधुरम गमनम मधुरम मधुराधिपते अखिलम मधुरम. Which means all the pervasive scene of sweetness and elegance is not only reflect quality but excellence as well. Any management today, the ultimate focus on excellence can never be ignored. Thus, it has been found that aspect of Indian ethos is globally accepted and applicable.
And the other one could be the joy of performing one function. As per the law of Purusharth, if one is doing naturally, he will be performing extremely well. That becomes a byproduct of happiness which leads to success. Excellence in terms of enjoyment by performing is the third aspect of Indian ethos. It has been observed that these aspects are not only limited to India but also applicable universally.
Ethical values do not allow human beings to act voluntarily and unethically. Here I am concluding my discussion with one of the Vivekananda preaching. Aham Brahmasmi Tatitvamsi. God resides in me, God resides in you. For the overall development, growth and establishment, we need Indian ethos in our management system. Indian ethos teaches us our students devote themselves and work sincerely for the society, organization and environment. They will really enjoy their life through money, harmony and bliss. To make students ethically efficient and effective, our education system is on creative working, synchronizing the courses with Indian ethos as per the requirement.
I hope our today's discussion will be beneficial for you all to teach in subjects like Indian ethos and culture.
Namaste. Namaste.